individuals and CSOs in Vietnam, for instance. For instance, Vietnamese Union for Human Rights, which is the only CSO in Vietnam that is a member of from Asia, of its key leaders are now under travel ban. And later today, there will be a documentary show about Trần Thị Nga, a co-founder of that organization. He's now in jail. And with me right here is Ms. Xuân Mai. So she's a new member. She took the risk to travel. It took her 20 days to reach here. And she just received a
letter
from the police for questioning. So is there any measure that ACWC can take to ensure that at least those who try to engage that mechanism would be left alone and be in safety? Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, very, very quickly, I'm not asking anyone to bend themselves or bend themselves out of shape. Okay? I'm not saying that. I'm not a student of international politics, but I understand now that a lot of human rights language and words that are used by governments, CSOs have to also play the game, because it's a lot of it is the game is a lot of, I don't like to use the word, but it's hypocrisy. So you take advantage, for CSOs, you take advantage of the hypocrisy in the terms that are used, whether you actually mean it or don't mean it. So I'm not asking you to bend out of shape. You do not need to bend out of shape to use language that you may not actually need to mean, but because it's acceptable and gets your agenda across the region. But that is, of course, for individual CSOs to decide on. So if I was wearing a CSO hat, I may not want to. Because for me, I do not want to engage the ASEAN mechanism. For us, we do strategic litigation locally, and we just do cases that we need to do cases on, and do education on the ground. Our CSO is very focused on not needing to engage or not wanting to engage ASEAN mechanism.